is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Marty in Worcester. Hey, Marty, what's going on?
Hi, Mr. O'Brien. How are you?
I'm doing great. How you been, man?
Not bad. You know, you guys, over the time and with a few of your courses and seminars, you know, you taught me how to fish.
That's a beautiful thing, brother.
Yeah, it's true. And so what happens is I still listen all the time, and to not only you, but some of the others.
Sure.
To get an idea where the fish might be biting. As far as your services, they're a bargain. When you compare them to a certain prominent man with real estate courses at $35,000 and no contact with the lecturers afterwards at all, and you think of what you guys do for a few hundred, and you can get access and ask questions forever, you know, it's a great deal.
No, no, we appreciate the growling problem with us.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Love is kind and just. When your lover smiles always on your face, you feel good about yourself, and because you are happy, you are kind. Love is also just. When you make a mistake, you pay only once for that mistake. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow down 28, NASDAQ off 7, S&P's down 3.5, gold contract down $6.80, trading at 1202.50, silver down 31 cents, $16.98 an ounce, platinum down 10 bucks, $9.36 an ounce, copper down 2 pennies at $2.56 a pound, light sweet crude off a buck, $49.22 a barrel. Notes, 10-year note down 10 ticks, 122.26. 30-year bond off a full point, 146.27. King dollar down 206 ticks, 101.745. The euro is at 105, and the yen is trading at 114.92. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Well, know what's going on in your world and the world of the S&Ps. Let's take a look at them. What do you have out here? Okay, so if we look at the SPY right now, you get a sideways move in the SPY. You're down 8 pennies. What we did do yesterday is that you got lower. You had an expansion of volume. What's going to be interesting out here today is that at the beginning of the day, the market was trying to bounce on light volume, but we've had some volatility, and it looks like we are going to actually have a higher volume day. That would be saying you're going to do like 20 million shares inside the SPY in the last hour, which can be done real easy on a day like today. We're at 57 million right now. And I expect what you're going to see, a little bit more volatility as we come into the close out here today. We go into the Dow Industrials. What do you have with the Dow Industrials? Same type of setup in the Dow. You're down 17 bucks. The Dow has got as low as 20,777 today. Right now, you're at 840. So only down 14 bucks. The gap that it was going into is 20,841, and we're at 20,840.20. So that number there on the Dow is going to be a big one today, because if you close over that, that's saying, hey, guess what? You're filling the gap, and you're going back topside. NASDAQ Composite. What do we have with the Composite? Same type of setup inside the Composite. The difference being that the Composite is in its lower range. And, you know, the Composite was only outside that range for a couple of days. The range we're talking about is 58.64. You're at 58.34 right now. And you do have, yesterday, you had light volume as we went higher, because the Composite did go higher yesterday as the S&Ps and the Dow went lower. And we'll see whether we get higher volume today. It looks like at this particular point we will. We're at 1.4 billion right now. That's saying that you could get a good 1.9 billion today. If we go look at the 3Qs, what do you have with the 3Qs? The low out here today is 130.14. Right now you're at 130.69. We've had two separate downdrafts, folks. Each one of them, bottom line, the market did get to come back. If we go take a look at the NQs, I'll show you what we were talking about here. So your first downdraft I believe it's about 10:30 this morning. Yeah, let's see. Yeah, it was on the open. So your first downdraft in the Qs, I mean the NQs, the futures, got down to a 53.47. They hung all day up at the highs of 53.66, and then just prior to coming on, they had a big swish all the way down to 53.35. So it's not only quite a swish on the way down. We're back 20 points on the way back up. So I expect what we're going to see out here is that volatility to continue. And, of course, what the market's trying to do is make it all the way back to positive right now. So we'll see how that shakes out. Gold contract. What do we have with gold? Gold contract out here. Let me just pull up. So we're trading down $7.20. You're at 1202. Gold's having a hard time catching a bid. That's the bottom line. You're coming into the strength. The strength that we're talking about is the strength from the 31st of January as well as the 17th of January. In both those cases, you had some big volume. We're talking about 247,000 contracts. Right now, we're at 216,000. Bottom line is that both gold and silver need to get a rejection of lower price, which we don't have yet. We go take a look at that silver contract, SIK7. What we have with silver out here, silver right now, traded down. It's down 30 cents. Big move on silver. That's a monster move, no doubt. You've done 63,000 contracts. Oh, excuse me, folks. You've done 63,000 contracts. You are trading into the strength from the 27th as well as the 17th. They're both trading into the same thing. What has happened is this, is that silver actually caught up with... Excuse me, folks. Silver caught up with the gold contract. The first couple of days, silver didn't go back downtown. Then it got toasted pretty good, real good, actually, on the 2nd of March. Goes sideways again in the last 3 days. So both of those right into that strength area. Notes, the 10-year note, what you have with the 10-year note is this. They have broken the swing low. This is the 30-year broke the swing yesterday. Now, dramatically lighter volume, but bottom line, this hasn't been able to catch a bid also. We're at 122.26. It broke the swing low from the 15th, which is the 123.06, as well as 123. Right now, yeah, that baby's still struggling. There's no doubt about it. You get the last time that we had big volume down was yesterday at the 123.05 area. But unless it catches the bid, bottom line, that baby looks to be that it would stay at the lower price points as we come into the close today. We go take a look at the 30-year bond. 30-year bond, same setup. 30-year bond, this took another leap down at 150 this afternoon. We went from 147.04 to 146. 21. And King Dollar. Good old King Dollar. You know, King Dollar, folks, bottom line is that King Dollar's got a big seller still laying at this January 5th time frame. You know, you're down 211 ticks. Bottom line is that they shot everything at King Dollar at approximately, 9 o'clock this morning. You stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.
TFNN has just launched a special event in Tampa with Tom O'Brien taking place March 18th, sponsored by Nadex. Tom O'Brien will be presenting two workshops for a combined 2.5 hours of education, bisecting and dissecting his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System. March 18th kicks off with a continental breakfast as we get everyone checked in, and that is followed by two 75-minute workshops with Tom O'Brien. The first workshop from 8:45 until 10 a.m. will cover quality volume, cause and effect, and ABC structures, and the second workshop from 10:15 until 11:30 a.m. will cover swing points, testing, and the Tiger Gartley. Tom will then wrap things up with a question and answer session, which will be followed by a Tiger Luncheon Social on the rooftop of the Westin Hotel. The best part is that it's all free, but you must register to attend. Visit the front page of TFNN.com for all the details and to sign up today, and we hope to see you in Tampa on March 18th.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, two times currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is down 3. NASDAQ is flat. S&Ps are down 1. If you want to see, you know, the volatility is here in spades, folks. There's no two ways about this. We just went in the Dow. So if we take this back, at 1 o'clock, the Dow was at 20,862. We get down to 20,777 at 2 o'clock, and we're right back to 20,852 at quarter past 3. We take a look at the, let's go inside the Dow Industrials and see what the strength versus the weakness is. Strength out here, you have Johnson & Johnson is up, let me do it this way. We're gonna do the points. So putting strength into the Dow, you get Johnson & Johnson putting 13 points in, Travelers is putting 5, 3M putting 3, DuPont 3. Taken away from it is Big Blue. Big Blue is the big mover out here. Big Blue is down 18. You have Caterpillar taking 13 away. Boeing's taking 6 away. Apple's taking 3 away. Let's go take a look at the yen. All the tigers are talking about the yen in here. Let's see what we have happening with this yen. So, well, the yen's up 61. You're at 114.96. That's been testing the highs here, the 114.97. That move, though, just did come. Well, it just moved from 114.83 to the 114.96. And, yeah, that's the number that everyone's looking at, because that was the high that was established out here on February 15th. That was the high, 114.75 on March 3rd. That is, you know, right where, well, that's basically, ICE is laying out at 115.22, actually. So ICE is a little bit higher than that. When we came off the highs, and that's kind of how the dollar's set up. If we go, let's go take a look at the dollar on the other side of that. So DXM7. Yeah, the dollar hasn't moved at all. The yen is just a movement out here. Dollar hasn't moved at all. We go back, let's go back inside the NDX 100. We'll see what's moving inside the NDX 100. Putting strength into is Regeneron. That's up 2.6%. You have Celgene up 1.9%. QVC, Liberty, let's see, what do they go under? There's so many different Liberties. Liberty Interactive. This is QVC, is up 1.5%. Mondelez is up 1.5%. Taken away from it, American Airlines is down 3.3%. You have Seagate Technology off 3.2%. Fastenal is down 2.7%. And Western Digital is down 2.5%. Some of the higher volume equities in this market, let's see how we're laying out here. So you have Bank of America is up 5 cents. You have Frontier up 12 cents. Marathon Oil is up 91. Snap is up 11. You get Rite Aid down 5 cents. GE is down 13. Citigroup is up 39. Freeport Mac Moran is down 7. Yeah, Tailored Brands is the one that's getting smoked out here today. It's down $7.50. Tailored Brands is Men's Warehouse, Joseph A. Banks. That they are just getting toasted in a huge way. No two ways about that. Let's go over to the IBB. We take a look at the IBB. IBB right now, sideways move. IBB is having a hard time getting over this 301. You know, it made it up to the 303.74, closed at 299.79. That was the test of the 301.80 back from the 23rd of September. You know, let's go REGN. If we look at Regeneron, because that's putting juice into it today, Regeneron's up 948. That's going to the top of its range. That looks like it wants to test, yeah, the 396. 396.67. That's the way that's laying out. Oil, we go over that oil contract. You know, oil no doubt got toasted and roasted. And when you take a look at this oil contract, what you have is, you know, this baby had been teetering for a good month. Yeah, we start teetering January 10th, actually. We didn't break down until, that's February, March. Actually, that was two full months. With the oil contract I've been doing, folks, okay, it was just teetering, trying to stay above the 54.17. You know, it would sneak underneath it, get above it again. Sneak underneath it, get above it again. And then it just blew out of the water. And what you do have with oil, you know, yesterday we did 323,000 contracts. Today you did 329. You're going into a OPEC day. So OPEC, that was November 30th. November 30th is that when they come out with their basically, you know, getting together as a cartel once again, hoping they could keep prices up. That's when oil went from $48 to $52. And then 2 weeks that Saturday night, then we went all the way up to 57. Bottom line, once it cut into that area, it cut in with big volume. That's saying, number one, you're going to go to 48, 45. Larger yet, though, is that this has a high volume low at that $45 level. You know, if we go over to the XLE, you take a look at the XLE. XLE is set up the exact same way. Let's go take a look at that. So the XLE right now is flat. You know, that came down hard. And what the XLE has, folks, is that you're at $69.65. So 69.88 happens to be, you know, you get some support there. And what that is, that's where we came off the low September 28th. You know, the low there was $66.14. You come off that low, you had the price strength, you had the volume, all of the above. You know, bottom line is this will end up making its way back to that low, that swing low. Because what you're going to have here now is that now you're going to have, you got the breakdown on the daily. You're going to have the breakdown with volume on the weekly. You know, in order for this to, the XLE this is, in order for the XLE to reject this, this would have to close tomorrow over $70.98. You know, because what's laying out here is $66.14 and more than likely, what you're going to see is that that little baby is going to come down there. It's going to try to take that out. It's going to get intriguing coming into this closeout here because we haven't had volatility like this in quite a while. And what I mean specifically, if we go over, watch this. If we go over to the, it doesn't matter whether you go to the S&Ps or the ES. It doesn't matter what index you actually go to. what you're going to see is that the fastness of the move down was there as well as the move back up. You know, thus far, though, what we have out here is that you have that high volume low laying right out here that wants to be tested in the S&P, which is a 2151. So it's going to be pretty wild. We're just trying to watch this baby. They definitely got it going, you know, coming up to this higher level. And they haven't busted into the higher level. The higher level intraday is only a few dollars above this. Actually, it's only two. 2361. Right now at 2359. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials right now down six. NASDAQ is off two. S&P's are down one. We'll be right back.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
If you're looking to unearth a new financial resource and diversify your financial portfolio, consider the new market-safe core commodity CD from EverBank. This five-year U.S. dollar-denominated CD gives you exposure to four equally weighted commodities, gold, copper, WTI oil, and sugar, in one powerful CD. With no pricing caps, you can potentially earn an unlimited upside payment at maturity if the commodities increase in value across semi-annual pricing dates. And should the opposite occur, your principal is 100% protected. Keep in mind, returns are based on CD performance. There's no annual percentage yield or periodic rate of interest on this index CD. Don't miss out. With certain commodities on the rebound, now is the time to take advantage. The March 23rd funding deadline will be here before you know it. So call 1-855-750-4051 or visit everbank.com/TFNN for the CD's term sheet and other important product details and disclosures. Once more, that's 1-855-750-4051 or visit everbank.com/TFNN. This advertisement is sponsored content. EverBank is a member FDIC.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is down four. You get the NASDAQ flat. S&P's are flat. If we go take a look at, this is going to get kind of interesting. You know, we take a look at the implied probabilities of the rate hike. Now, this is the first time that I haven't looked at this for 2 days. But every implied volatility probability for the rate hike is 100%, folks. Okay, so it's pretty wild. March 15th, of course, it's 100% across the board. Now, the thing that's going to be really wild here is watching the next hike. And right now, this is where this is going, and this is pretty intense. So the probability of the next hike let's see, I'm going to make sure I'm reading this right. So right now we're at zero. Now we're at 25 to 50. Then 50 to 75. That's this column right here. Okay, so 100%. So then the next hike from, one second, we're at 25 to 50, 50 to 75. Oh, yeah, hey, so check this out. 75 to 1. One second, let me look at this for a second. I got to figure out, are we at right now? Oh, yeah, okay, now we're at 50 to 75. That's, so then 75 to 1 goes there. Okay, so here it is. So after the rate hike, this, you know, March 15th, then it goes up to 47% again, that there'd be another rate hike June 14th. May would be only 8.9% right now. June 14th is 47.6. So that's going up pretty quick. There's no two ways about that. The, yeah, that's, so we'll see where that shakes out. Let's see, so we're on the, please look at this, they're all positive. This is a mind blower. Yeah, March 9th. So right now you get the Dow up 2, the NASDAQ is up 2, S&Ps are flat. And let's go over to the IWM. Let's go take a look at the small caps out here. Small caps out here, they still can't catch a bid. It's going to be interesting. So the small caps are the first ones to make that U-turn. They're getting close to the lower end of the consolidation. That lower end of the consolidation, the IWM, is 133.12. And right now you're at 135.42. The high that the small caps had hit was 140.86. And they are continuing to have, yeah, they still haven't got the bounce that the Qs, the SPYs, or the diamonds got. The Qs right now are about 18 cents. They rejected that lower price out there. So we're at 130.94. The top of that gap was 130.45. We take a look at the SPYs. SPYs out here are up 35 cents. The top of that gap is 236.95. And right now at 236.91. Diamonds, we take a look at the diamonds. Diamonds right now, the top of that gap on the diamonds is 208.31. And got down to 207.86. Now, what the diamonds do have, this is going to be intriguing. The diamonds got a good expansion of volume here, man. You know, yesterday that went down 3.1, today 3.7. So that's an indication that those babies will get back down into that level. And we'll just see, you get 26 minutes coming into the close. That's a long time coming into the close out here. Euro, we go take a look at the euro out here. Euro is trading 105.88. And this looks like it's going to make that run for 106.40. That's where it seems to be shaking out. Let's go to Al in Tampa. Hey, Al, what's going on?
Not much, Tom. I'm looking forward to your March 18th show coming up.
Oh, good.
I went to one of your seminars over in Orlando, and it was top-notch, and that just lets your people know that it's worth every bit of it, especially since you're doing it for free. I can't believe it. I think I paid, $200-$300 before to do it, and now I'm going to be able to get it for free. That's pretty good.
Yeah, that's a beautiful thing. And folks, I'm glad you just brought it up. If you go to the front page of TFNN, you'll see we're doing a workshop. I'm doing a workshop next Saturday. Nadex is sponsoring it. That workshop, folks, is at the Western Tampa. Starts at 7:30 in the morning, goes to about noon, and then we're going to have a tiger party afterwards. So check it out on the front page of TFNN. What are we going to look at?
Well, I'm getting into the stock that I'm messing around with. I'm just trading it, and it's Liquid Lumber.
Okay, let's take a look at it. We got Lumber Liquidators. LL is the symbol. It's trading $17.71. Okay, so this is an equity that has had some heavy volatility, no doubt. Let me pull this back. Okay.
Well, I went and got it for $15.50, and then I sold it at $19.50.
Yeah.
And then looking at a pullback, it gapped up, and I'm just wondering, do you think it's going to come back to the $15.50 again?
I don't know. It looks like it's in a consolidation. It looks like the top of that base first is like $18.90. You know, I mean, this is a mess, but the bottom line is that it has been consolidating out here since May of 2015. This was the one that I forget what the exact scandal was, whether it's something was in the wood or something, right?
Yeah, the formaldehyde in the wood from China.
Right, right.
And they thought they were going to have all the suits, and they ended up dodging a bullet. They were looking at, I heard, going ahead and doing another offering to pay off all the problems, but I'm just wondering, it's going to come back and fill that gap back at 15 or right where you have it at the end there? It just gapped up. I wasn't expecting the gap up. I was going to get in. I was hoping it was going to pull back to the next level, and I missed it.
Yeah, no, I see what you're saying. I mean, I would wait. It'd be better to wait, you know, you know, if it fills it, great, you can get in, you know, because where you are right now, there's no doubt. I mean, you know, it looks to me like it wants to test the 1890, you know, but what you have that can be very quickly is that you have, that can gap down and fill that gap in a second, too. Do you know what I'm saying? So, you're right.
What I'm just saying is like your rule is that you, if the S&Ps are going, if the river's going down, you don't expect your stock to go up usually. You know what I'm saying? You don't fight the trend. So I'm just wondering if the S&Ps are going to do a little bit of a pullback, and it might take this down to the fill the gap.
That would be the best place that you could get in, especially when you're, you know, trading this for 3 or 4 days at a time or something. Do you know what I'm saying?
Well, I'm training it to a range, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Within the cycle and that, and I'm not getting too greedy, and I'm taking just my cash and I'm leaving the stock on the table so I have no gain. So I'm built, you know what I'm doing.
Yes.
So that's what I was looking at doing.
Yeah, wait for it to get down there, man. That's what to do.
Okay, thank you, Tom.
Looking, brother. See you next Saturday.
Yeah, see you Saturday.
Okay, cool. Have a great one. Have a safe one. You stay right there, folks. We're coming right back. Dow Industrials right now up 5. Nasdaq's up 3. S&P's are up 1.5. We're going to be right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information, in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen, live, during those shows, and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den, absolutely free, for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien. Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is flat. You get the NASDAQ up one. S&P is a flat. Let's go to Steve in Houston, Texas. Hey, Steve, what's going on?
Hey, Tom. Thanks for taking my call. I appreciate that.
Sure. Thanks for calling. Thanks for holding. Appreciate it.
Yep. I was looking at, you know, these oil stocks are getting hammered somewhat, although some are up today in pretty good volume. But I was looking at Marathon, and Marathon's got a big old gap down there around 13 or so, 13 to, I guess, 14, somewhere back in November. Do you think it might go down there and fill that particular gap?
Let's take a look at it. So you got Marathon Oil. The low for the year is 965. The high is 1928. Okay, so. Yeah, see what you're looking at. Well, let's see. Yesterday. Oh, you're looking way down there. I got it. Okay, cool. Are you looking at $13, right? That.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. No, I see that. Yeah. Yeah, they can do it easy. You know, you got. Well, actually, hey, this is pretty cool. This is a confirmed ABC down. Let me do this a different way. One second. Hold it. If I put this on. It's close.
I happen to like the company itself, yeah. and what they've got. But, you know, looking at it price-wise, you sure. know, and from a chart standpoint, you know, you've always told us, you know, those lower gaps generally want to get filled, so.
And this has a high volume, you know, swing point there. I mean, yeah, we take a look at this in the daily, what you have is this. You broke the swing yesterday, you broke it with good volume. You know, we went down hard. You know, today's a good day because it's going back inside the range. And normally what would happen there is that, you know, we'll see how it perform tomorrow. Probably won't be able to make it over 1658. But you broke the swing, did it with volume. That opens up that $13.10 for sure.
Yeah, you know? And you're coming back today, which was nice action today to come back up to test at least, because that's pretty good volume coming back up today.
It is good volume. Now, this is where it gets a little bit tougher to understand that, okay, so you're coming up with volume. You know, is that showing strength? What will happen is that, yeah, that is showing strength because they're back inside the range. But then what you have is that as soon as you flip this to the weekly, then all that's going to do, that's just putting more volume into the lows.
Yeah, you know? So that 13 looks like...
It looks better. Yeah. Yes, it does.
Yeah.
And then if we go over here, if I show you one of the larger ones, Exxon Mobil also, you know, is getting a little juice out here today. It's rejecting its low, but watch this. Exxon, folks, okay, and Exxon has been the leader on the way down here. This little baby has a high volume low. The high of the low is $75. And it looks to me like, you know, what saved it this time was the high of the second low, which is $79.92. You know, we went to $80. But Exxon looks to me like it's building cars to try to get after that. So if Exxon's going after that, you know, Marathon's going to end up going after it also.
Because it seems like all these oil stocks, they started falling first before the price of crude went. Crude's kind of looks like it's catching up right
they
now.
They did. You know, when you take a look at the XLE, folks, topped out on December 12th.
It's right.
You know, that's a long time compared to where we are in the marketplace, man. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, so I'm thinking that 13 might be a good spot, at least to.
It's definitely worth waiting for it.
Yeah. Okay. All righty. Tom, thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Have a great one. Have a safe one.
You too. Bye.
Let's see. Dow right now is up 6, folks. Nasdaq's up 2. S&Ps are up 1.5. This is quite a comeback from that downdraft. Let's go to Kevin in California. Hey, Kevin, what's going on?
Hey, Tom, how are you?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
I'm doing fine. Thank you for taking my call.
Absolutely.
I just have a quick question here. Back in February, you had said you thought that the GLD was in the confirmed ABC up, but then started acting a little squirrely, and you thought maybe it was in a complex ABC up. I'm just wondering if there's anything now that has invalidated your thinking on that, and whether you still believe it's going to complete that ABC.
Yeah, it's as to the question of would it validate my thinking. An ABC up or down is a mathematical deal, and it's still in one. The complex part of it is that we're at 114.43. So you can see you break topside with 10 million. We're coming underneath that with 5.6. You know, it's like, okay, man.
I just didn't know if maybe that might be invalidated by having gotten back inside that lower range that it broke out from.
No, that's what the complex one does do. That's what it does.
Oh, okay. So yeah. That's the definition there.
Yeah. Now, what it has to do, this is what it has to do, though, okay, the bottom line. Now, it's still fulfilling that. It's coming back inside with light volume. But then, of course, then when you break topside again, well, you know, it's got to reject lower price, go topside, and have some juice behind the move.
Yeah. You know? It's funny. I mean, the last caller who was talking about oil stocks, I mean, something similar had happened where the equities, the miners, in the HUI and XAU had started to diverge from the gold price.
Big time.
The thing happened with, you know, energy.
Right.
And it's looking now, I've just pulled up a chart, like a three-month chart of the HUI, and there are now a couple of gaps down beneath right where we're sitting, you know, and it just looks like, I'm wondering if there's going to be another quick whoosh down to make this, 100% move where it retraces the entire breakout from December 28th.
It feels it.
Or, I'm sorry, December.
I know what you're saying, 23rd. Man. I get it, and there's no doubt. And what he's talking about, folks. So the strength came in on December 29th as well as 30th. You know, now the HUI talking about 179.66. You get below that, yeah. You get below that, man. The bottom line is that, you know, it won't be good.
Yeah, and also too, there's another gap down on December 23rd up to the.
There's plenty of gaps because what happens in the between the HUI and the XAU. You know, these gold stocks, they trade in London. You get gaps. You get a lot of gaps in there. I'm more concerned that you get under that level, period. That's where we had the wide price spread. That's why we had the accelerated volume. That's in all of them. Do you know what I'm saying? You know,
sure.
So you get underneath that and it's a problem. And we know that rates are going up, you know, and so it's like, okay.
Yeah, but it's funny. I mean, that's been a virtual lock, at least in the Fed Fund futures for weeks now. You'd think that would be discounted in the price at some point, but the hammering's just been relentless.
And what that's all about, I suspect, is this, is that if, in fact, the Fed is going to go up every meeting, folks, okay, which is very possible, you know, then the metals market will have a problem, the broad market will have a problem, and we haven't been used to the Fed going up for so long, just once, never mind four to six times in a row. I've seen them go up 4 to 6 times in a row, and it's vicious.
Well, you know what? I mean, I have another question about that, if you don't mind. I mean, it's not as if, you know, historically it's been impossible for gold to rise as interest rates rise, even during an interest rate tightening cycle, even during high interest rates. I mean, if you look back at 79 to 81 or in, 2001
to
2008.
Just stay right there. We come right back, okay?
Okay.
You stay right there, folks. Come right back. Dow Industrials right now up 3. Nasdaq's up 1. S&Ps are up 1. We're going to be right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. We're talking with Kevin, and we're talking about the gold market, and we're talking about interest rates. You know, my bottom line, Kevin, is that if, in fact, rates continue to go up a quarter every time they meet, man, inflation really better be running in order for this gold price to move. Because if it's not, it's not going to move. In fact, it's going to move, but move down rather than up.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, but it really does look like inflation, you know, has kind of kicked up globally. I mean, if you look at a lot of the charts of the of commodities and, you know, various commodity indices, we really do seem to have inflation, which would keep, you know, the real rate negative.
No, I agree. That's where my head's at. Because that's one of the main reasons is that this rally here, and I was talking to Rob McEwen about this, and I was talking to, and he's the CEO of McEwen Mining. I was with him over the weekend, and I was talking to Bob Archer. This rally here is different than the rally that we had from 2000 going all the way up to 2006. It just, it's trading different. Everything about it is different. I haven't quite figured out, like, why. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, what specifically do you notice? What about the character of it is different? Because that interests me.
It's because people continue to buy. I mean, if this was on the first rally, gold would be down to $800 right now in a second. You know what I mean? Yeah. It is, you know. And it's not. It's still at 1,200. I mean, you know, the last couple of weeks have been, you know, haven't been easy. But, you know, It's not. They're having a hard time selling it down. And the dollar, you know, for everything you were talking about, you know, the dollar should be to the moon because of the amount of, you know, rate hikes that are out, that supposedly going to be happening. And there's a seller inside the dollar that's pretty intense.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, I mean, that makes me wonder, ultimately, you know, if the Fed really is going to be able to continue, you know, hiking rates like they're bluffing they are, especially given some of the recent GDP reports that just came out. I don't know if you saw earlier in the week, but Atlanta Fed drastically revised their most recent GDP report lower, which just makes me wonder, you know, if the Fed's going to be able to continue to raise rates if the economy does, in fact, continue on such a tepid pace.
Well, and I guess the larger thing is that, like, right now the 10-year is it's almost at 2.6. And when you look at the world rates, we're still really high. You know, when I look at that, I'm saying to myself, okay, you know, so what that says, okay, by the way, folks, is that it is saying that people want more money to lend to us versus Europe. That doesn't make any sense at all. You know, to me it doesn't anyway, you know. You know, we're in much better shape than Europe. So it's like, okay, so, you know, how does that shake out? You know, we're going to find out real soon. I mean, you know, one of the tigers in the den was saying, well, I guess for the last time that, you know, that we finally got that saying that, yes, they're going to raise the rate, then gold took off. I think the biggest risk is that they're bullish now, their hands are untied, and they're going to say quarter, 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 quarter.
Yep, you know? They might. They might. Yeah. Next week's going to be interesting, too, with the debt ceiling. We don't really know what's going to go on with that. If that turns into, you know, a fiasco where the Republicans come in and say, you know, they really don't want to raise rates and make a big deal out of that, that could really jostle the market.
Well, I think one of the friend of gold right now is Trump and the Republicans. That's the friend of gold. That's the reality. That's my reality. And the reason being is that what you're going to see is you're going to see, I have a hard time comprehending that they're going to say they're going to raise the debt ceiling after the amount of times that they fought raising it. I mean, there's a core in there that's not going to raise it. They're going to fight it out, man. So
right, it's going to be fascinating. Next week we could see some real fireworks.
I'm telling you.
Well,
man.
Thanks, Tom.
Okay, have a great one. Have a safe one. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials right now up 2, Nasdaq's down 1, S&P's are flat. We're going to be right back.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Dave in Clearwater. Hey, Dave, Happy New Year. What's happening, man?
Happy New Year to you, my brother. How are you, sir?
I'm doing great, man. How you been?
I am doing well, man. I'm doing well. Can I throw a quote out at you?
Sure.
In the market, somebody knows something. Someone always knows something. That statement was made by a great trader by the name of Tom O'Brien about 6-7 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
And it kind of hit me like a brick. Well, you're right. Somebody always knows something.
Hey, Carlos, what's going on, brother?
I'm calling you back, Tom. This morning I had a pleasure to talk to you and your son, and I don't want to miss the opportunity to talk to you again.
Well, I think you made some money on this bond.
Oh, yes, Tom. Your newsletter helped me.
That's a beautiful thing. We appreciate the growl and prowl on us out here.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Accept others the way they are. You cannot change other people. To try to change them is to fit what you want is like trying to change a dog into a cat. A cat into a horse. They are what they are, and you are what you are. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 2, NASDAQ up 1, S&P's flat, gold contract down $7.50, trading at $12.01 an ounce. Silver down 30 cents, $16.99 an ounce. Platinum down 10 bucks, $9.36 an ounce. Copper off 2.5 pennies, $2.56 a pound. Light sweet crude down 61 cents, trading at $49.67 a barrel. Notes, 10-year note, down 11 ticks, 122.25. 30-year bond off a full point and 4 ticks, 146.25. King dollar, down 166 ticks, trading at 101.785. The euro is at 105, and the yen is trading at 114.95. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? You get a sideways market. The SPY out here did 84 million shares. Now, what you have here, this is going to be pretty cool, watching how this shakes out. So, yesterday, you came downtown, you did 78 million. When I started at 3 o'clock, you were at 58 million. Sure enough, bottom line is that you get a lower low, you get 84 million. Flat market, volatile market. Intraday, you had the first downdraft at the opening of the market. And then you had a very large one that came in at 2 o'clock. And that baby, we had the SPY go from 236.95 down to 235.74 and come right back topside. But what that did, though, however, is throw volume into the marketplace. Dow Industrials, exact same type of setup in the Dow. We had the price spread today in the Dow was 130 points, big spread. And you ended up being up 2. Dow Industrials closed at 20,858, and that number is over the gap. So comes down, fills the gap, stays over the gap. And that's saying, coming as a jobs number tomorrow, we'll see whether it's going to make a run for this 957 area. Right now you're at 858. 957 would be the top of the gap. That's where the Dow Industrials had gapped higher on March 1st. NASDAQ Composite, same setup in the composite. In the Dow, we end up doing 855 million versus 889. The NASDAQ did 1.86 billion versus 1.80. Now, the NASDAQ, the composite, stayed in the lower range. You know, the lower range inside the composite is anything under 58.66. Right now, you're at 58.38. You know, that dropped in the lower range this Monday. So, bottom line is that we'll see whether that wants to get into the 5,800 area. If we look at the three Qs, what you have with the three Qs, did 18 million shares. You got down to a price point of 130.14. And, you had an expansion of volume into a lower price. Now, that being said, the Qs are in the higher range because in order to get back in the lower range, Qs would have closed under 130.70. And right now you're at 130.84. Gold contract. We need a gold contract. Just can't catch a bid, folks. And we're coming into a Friday. This is going to be pretty intense. Because Fridays are pretty bad inside the metals market, particularly when you've been in a downtrend. And this metals contract has been in a downtrend since the 27th of February. Each day it's gone down. Right now, your lowest swing point on this is 1182. You know, we're at 1201 right now. Volume's light, but guess what? You know, you get that lower swing coming into jobs number tomorrow. It's going to be highly volatile. No two ways about that. Silver, we take a look at the silver market. Silver took a beating out here today. Silver was down 1.7%. And where gold was only down 0.6%. But if we go take a look at that silver market, silver is at $16.99. You've done 65,000 contracts. There she is. Yeah, so silver's going to try to test 1670. 1670 is where the strength was on the 17th. The low of that is 1688, actually. And then we came down and tested that again on the 27th of January. And on the 27th of January, that's where we went from $16.70 up to $17.30. Notes, the 10-year note broke its lowest swing point today. Had light volume, but bottom line couldn't hold price. You're down 11 ticks. You're at 122.25, and the swing point we're talking about was the 123 area. We did 1.1 million contracts, which is really light. Bottom line is that it's got to catch a bid, and hasn't caught a bid yet. 30-year bond broke its swing point, I believe, 2 days ago. Yeah, yesterday. No, it broke it yesterday. So the 30-year broke its lowest swing yesterday. That is trading at 146.26, and 147.21 is the number. King dollar. What do we have with king dollar? King dollar, folks, bottom line, keeps getting sold off at the January 5th downdraft. Right now we're on the June contracts, and the number on the June contract goes from 102.420. The low is 101.240. We got to a price point today of 102.125, and bottom line, they just sold it right down from that level. And you know, try to make it back, but just couldn't make it back. That was sold on at 9 o'clock this morning. And what that was all about, that was when Draghi came on from the European Central Bank. And bottom line is the European Central Bank was getting a little more bullish and not so bearish, I mean, not so dovish in the euro, and how they were going to basically, you know, keep putting money into the market. Bottom line is that brought the euro up slightly, and it brought the dollar down slightly. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials finished up 2. NASDAQ up 1.5. S&P's up 2.5. We're going to be right back.
TFNN has just launched a special event in Tampa with Tom O'Brien taking place March 18th, sponsored by Nadex. Tom O'Brien will be presenting 2 workshops for a combined 2.5 hours of education, bisecting and dissecting his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System. March 18th kicks off with a continental breakfast as we get everyone checked in, and that is followed by 2 75-minute workshops with Tom O'Brien. The first workshop from 8:45 until 10 a.m. will cover quality volume, cause and effect, and ABC structures, and the second workshop from 10:15 until 11:30 a.m. will cover swing points, testing, and the Tiger Gartley. Tom will then wrap things up with a question and answer session, which will be followed by a Tiger Luncheon Social on the rooftop of the Westin Hotel. The best part is that it's all free, but you must register to attend. Visit the front page of TFNN.com for all the details and to sign up today, and we hope to see you in Tampa on March 18th. Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades
open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials finished up two. You had the NASDAQ up one. S&P's up two. And as we do each and every Thursday at 20 past the second hour, we have our man, Mr. Basil Chapman. Don't forget, folks, Basil does a great show right here at TFNN every trading day, 11 to 12 Eastern Standard Time. Also, there's a great newsletter, The Opening Call. The way you can test drive that is to come over to our website at TFNN, go to newsletters, go to trading newsletters, see The Opening Call. You can test drive that 30 days absolutely free. And, of course, no matter where you are listening right now, if you happen to be listening to car radio, whether it's the East Coast, West Coast, Rocky Mountains, remember that you can get us 24 hours a day, folks, right on your cell phone. You go to TFNN.com, just hit Tiger TV. You're going to get some great HD quality video as well as audio.
Hi, Tom. How are you?
I'm doing great. Yourself?
Very good. Welcome back. We missed you over here.
Thanks so much. Thanks for doing the show with Tommy. I was listening to you guys up in Toronto, Canada. It was a beautiful thing. It's amazing.
It's very nice.
Technology is, I'm telling you, folks, I was listening on my phone up in Toronto. It was blowing my mind. It always blows my mind, but it's really funny even being in another country. Just click, click. There it is, right there.
It is. It's quite amazing. And not only that, you know, when I exercise in the morning, I listen to Larry.
Yes.
It's just fabulous. And the clarity is really terrific.
It is. Some reason, I don't know if it's small because it's on a phone, the clarity looks better than on a computer, folks. It's funny, isn't it? I think it's just
terrific.
Yeah. So what are we looking at today, Basil?
So a couple of things. Last week when we spoke, what I said was I believe that I'm very close to getting some kind of a pullback in the Dow charts that I'm looking at and the S&P, the key indices. And that at that particular time, the stochastic, one of the technical tools, anyone's looking, the chart on the left here is the daily. The one in the middle is the weekly.
Okay.
One on the right is the monthly. And the daily, the shorter term, had the stochastic way up in the 97, 98 area. That is very unusual. And what happens normally is as long as it's staying up there, and I always say almost every textbook on technical analysis says that over 80% in the stochastic is what they term overbought and under 20% is oversold. And I say, no, that's the wrong thinking. You want to be way over 80% in the stochastic because you can see when it just briefly went above 80% right there, that was January. All that happened was that there was a pop up in the Dow, then it came back down again. But as long as the MACD was acting well and the stochastic was holding steady, you got yourself a rising trend. And that's really what I like to see. Then now you can see it's starting to push down. In fact, the stochastics dropped very sharply to 63%. MACD has crossed negatively. And we've got, for the very first time in quite a while, we've got 6 bars since the March the 1st high, all-time high, of 21,169 in the Dow. So it's 6 bars. This is very unusual. We had it on the upside, but we haven't had it for a while on the downside. Lower highs and lower lows. But they're very tiny candles. You mentioned today that the Dow had an intraday move of over 100 points. We used to see that in within minutes at times. So this is going to be something very interesting because, as I say, the stochastic and the MACD are down. I've got enough information to say that there's a down arrow, which puts the Dow itself, the daily, in a sell mode. That's just an explanation that doesn't say, oh, my God, sell mode, now you're going to tank. It just says, because of the way the configuration is, the Dow is in a sell mode. So it means two things. One is if I just jump to the 120-minute charts here, I've got, this is the same chart. I've got it in different configurations, but it's the Dow 120. Today we went to a leg 5 in the Chapman Wave methodology I've developed, and a leg E, and there was a bounce. The same thing you can see here in the on the right side, same chart, except now I've got wider candles, and you've got the MACD and stochastic. You see the MACD is just trying to flatten out. Stochastic has, in fact, turned up. So this is the first time that there's some sign that says, hey, there could be a bounce. So that's going to be very interesting, whatever the report is. However the report tomorrow on jobs is perceived, what the market does, because it's ready for a bounce. But at this point, I still think it's a bounce. Now, what's really important is that we spoke about the weekly chart, and I had a question about this from someone in the den. What are all these yellows? Are these those bodies of the stalk leg? I said, no. Look, underneath it says the technicals. If you look at the technicals, you can see that from that sudden spike up, there was this number of bars sideways to down before the breakout. And then it got shorter. And look, all of a sudden, you got this very short one right here that broke out. That was on the 27th of January. After every one of these big spikes, you did get some kind of a consolidation. Now, for the first time, the weekly chart shows the stochastic pulling back just a little. It's 95%. That's still good. And the MACD is still holding well, but starting to turn down. So, you know, in my work, I just briefly bring this over. We're always looking for the Ds, the fourth highest peak, because other things can happen at that point. So there's your peak D, and this is the template that we always look for. Well, here we are in the month, the ABC, we're in leg D. So it's going to be very important. I still contend that the market has kind of limited upside now. It might have limited downside, but I think it's choppy to sideways. That's the way we, in my traders corner, that's for subscribers. This is the way we're looking at the market right now. We're actually in more of a cash position. You remember that crazy ETF that we were looking at, the DOD, the elements of the Dow, the dogs of the Dow?
Yes.
Well, we rode that all the way to a leg D, hit a round number 29. We're always looking for these round numbers on the 3rd of March. So we've been getting out. We started off down here at $18.05, and we're getting out all the way. And as we were getting towards the 28th, I said, okay, we're going to take some off. We're going to keep a little bit as a core. We kept that. And on that really sharp decline, yesterday it was a massive decline for no real reason, but there's a characteristic. It had the same decline back in February, so I had to be prepared for that. We got out, so now we're out. So we had some real nice profits from 20% to 58% gains in the different positions. Now we're watching it. So I think we're in a cash position, and I think I feel quite comfortable with it because there are certain stocks that have acted really well. I'd like to either get back in, or I'd like to look at them on the as longs. But at the same time, I don't think one needs to be afraid of looking at the short side. It's just that on the indexes, you can see the same thing happened on the S&P, SPX.X, there you are. S&P made a peak D, it's in a sell mode, should have a bit of a bounce based on the 120-minute chart, but I think we're looking at these key indices as slightly lower lows, slightly lower highs at this particular point. Look at the SMH has held well, the XLV, that's the healthcare, sort of held well so far, but I think we're in for this mild correction. I'm calling it, at least for now, a mild correction. We'll have to see. But look how many Ds. I just showed you that D in the weekly of the Dow. It's the same thing here in the S&P. I can go through so many indices in this leg D, possibly making a peak D. So I think it's time for, at least I think it's a time for caution right now.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how this number comes out tomorrow, because the bottom line is that it looks like the market's waiting for it again. I mean, that was a heck of a comeback today for the market, you know?
It was a very good comeback, but what we really need to be thinking of is that as far as the Fed is concerned, I've got a chart right here of the yields, and if you got a moment, I'll show you something very interesting. The 30-year, this is the 30-year, the white one. Brown is the 10-year yield, and the 5 is the T-note yield.
Yes.
And they are just within cents of breaking out from the previous high of the week of the 16th of December. Each one is just within cents of doing that. And Yellen has said, these are the criteria. I think we've met all the criteria that she wants to raise.
There's no doubt. Yeah, there's no doubt about that. No doubt. Basil, thank you so much. Look forward to the show tomorrow morning, 11 o'clock.
Thank you, Tom. Have a great evening.
Thank you. You stay right there, folks. We'll come right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Dow finished up 2, NASDAQ up 1.5, S&P's up 2.5. We're going to be right back.
If you're looking to unearth a new financial resource and diversify your financial portfolio, consider the new market-safe core commodity CD from EverBank. This 5-year U.S. dollar-denominated CD gives you exposure to 4 equally weighted commodities, gold, copper, WTI oil, and sugar, in one powerful CD. With no pricing caps, you can potentially earn an unlimited upside payment at maturity if the commodities increase in value across semi-annual pricing dates. And should the opposite occur, your principal is 100% protected. Keep in mind, returns are based on CD performance. There's no annual percentage yield or periodic rate of interest on this index CD. Don't miss out. With certain commodities on the rebound, now is the time to take advantage. The March 23rd funding deadline will be here before you know it. So call 1-855-750-4051 or visit everbank.com/TFNN for the CD's term sheet and other important product details and disclosures. Once more, that's 1-855-750-4051 or visit everbank.com/TFNN. This advertisement is sponsored content. EverBank is a member FDIC.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
TFNN has put together the finest live programming lineup each trading day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected financial minds in the nation to educate traders and investors. On Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, we broadcast 9 hours a day starting at 8 a.m. as John Logan kicks us off each trading day with the Global Market Pulse. Tuesdays and Thursdays, we broadcast 11 hours. Get an early and healthy start to your day as Nico and Paige bring you Living a Primal Lifestyle. Then catch Andy Hecht at 5 p.m. with the Commodities Hour. Following the Tom O'Brien Show, Mondays and Fridays, catch live trading on the Nadex platform with hosts Tom and Tommy O'Brien, along with Gerald Martin on the Bull Bear Binary Option Hour. See the TFNN program lineup via the link on the front page of TFNN.com to get a complete overview of our TFNN shows and hosts, and keep TFNN's Tiger TV tuned in on your mobile device, PC, or Mac for the latest financial news and information throughout the broadcasting day. TFNN, educating investors. This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. We go back inside the commodity market. We take a look at the commodity market out here today. You had natural gas. They come out with numbers today. That was up 2.2%. You had a drawdown that was kind of what they expected. Live cattle was up 0.4%. The rest of them, they're all red. You had nickel down 4%. Sugar was off 2. Orange juice was down 2. Silver 1.9. Gasoline unleaded right now, we're at 164. Let's actually go take a look at this and see what it's looking. So gasoline was down 2.5 pennies today. It said 77,000 contracts. As we're coming into the summer, yeah, this gas is going to get cheaper. So we got, I'd say 162 is your next stop. 162 was where it took off from, and that's the same November 30th. That was OPEC day, but you know, bottom line, it's really sliced right through that area. 173 was the top of it, 162 the bottom. We hit 162.63 today. So this looks like it's going to make its way. XB. Okay, so. I see. Oh, this is going to get interesting. So when I put the continuous contract up, it has a big monster gap. We're already in it. That's going to be wild watching this thing shake out on a weekly gap. So you're at 162, but this thing can actually get down to 153. That's the way that that's shaking out. So that's going to be intriguing watching that thing shake. See, the top of the range, which it couldn't hold, was 166. Now, we've been in the same consolidation since September of 2015. Pull this back a bit. This is pretty amazing, actually. Look at this. So 2008, well, man, I forget those days, thank God, meaning paying $3.60 for... So wholesale gasoline, folks, in July of 2008 was $3.63 wholesale. That crashes down to 78 cents. Wow. That's intense. Okay, so watch. July 2008, you're at $3.63. December, we're at 78 cents. No wonder why those people had such a tough time. That is an extraordinary crash. Then it climbed all the way back up to $3.48 again. July of 2011, stayed up there. Kind of, yeah, good year. August of 2012, it started drifting down again. Then the next plunge didn't come until June of 2014. June of 2014, bottom line, quite a plunge. Yeah, this is quite a story. They were just talking about this in the den. But listen to this. This is pretty intense. So in Japan, of course, you had the at Fukushima. Now, Fukushima, folks, is where the nuclear plant went radioactive. But listen to this. They descend on towns and villages, plundering crops and rampaging through homes. They occasionally attack humans, but perhaps the most dangerous of all, the marauders carry with them highly radioactive material. Hundreds of toxic wild boars have been roaming across northern Japan, where the meltdown of Fukushima nuclear plant 6 years ago forced thousands of residents to desert their homes, pets and livestock. Some animal, like cattle, were left to rot in their pens. As Japan prepares to lift some evacuation orders on four towns within the more than 12-mile exclusion zone around the Fukushima plant later this month, officials are still struggling to clear out the contaminated boars. Man, I'd never go back there. 12 miles, forget it. Wild boar meat is a delicacy in northern Japan, but animals slaughtered since the disaster are too contaminated to eat. According to tests conducted by the Japanese government, some of the boars have shown levels of radioactive material, cesium-137, that are 300 times higher than safety standards. Officials also expressed concern that the returning residents may be attacked by the animals, some of which have settled comfortably in the abandoned homes and have reportedly lost their shyness to humans. Yeah, they all have houses now. Photographs and video footage of the crisis hit Japan towns and villages are remnants of Chernobyl, where wildlife continues to thrive despite high radiation levels in the aftermath of the world's worst nuclear accident in 1986. With the absence of humans, Chernobyl and Ukraine has become a refuge for all kinds of animals, including moose, deer, bear, lynx, even wolves. Since the nuclear crisis in Fukushima in 2011, video footage taken by the journalists have shown packs of badly unkempt dogs scampering across roads. Rat colonies have overrun abandoned supermarkets. Farmland transformed into grassland has become a perfect habitat for wild boars and foxes. Boars have caused 856,000 in damage to agriculture. This is crazy. So boars have caused 854,000 in damage to agriculture in Fukushima, reported the Japanese newspaper. How do they can put even a number on it? The place is worth nothing. They're blaming the boars for eaten some of the agricultural when no one else is going to eat it. Oh, my God. Local authorities in towns across Fumajima have hired teams of hunters to cull the boars. It's unclear whether those efforts will pay off or whether they will have to persuade former residents to return home. Authorities in the town of Tomika have killed 800 so far, but officials say that's not enough, according to Japanese media. The latest statistics show that in the 3 years since 2011, the number of boars killed in hunts have grown to 13,000. Oh, my God, from 3,000. Pigs will eat anything, evidently, right? And in the government survey last year, more than half of the Fumijima's former residents said they wouldn't return, citing fears over radiation and safety of the nuclear plant, which will take 40 years to dismantle. It's pretty intense. Yeah, rent. Oh boy, I'm telling you, these disasters. The shame is that I suspect the people that are going to go back, they probably have nowhere else to go. But you go back to a place like that, they're talking about 12 square miles. That doesn't seem to be like a lot when you look at the aspect of nuclear radiation, how long it stays around. I mean, but the numbers are in the hundreds of years, not in 12 years. Not a good scene, no doubt. Let's go take a look at some of the higher volume stocks out here. I want to go take a look at the defense contractors. Boeing, if we take a look at Boeing. So Boeing down $1.17. Now, this has been a one-way run. You get September 16th, it's $126. Straight up to 185. You pull back slightly today. Boeing looks like it wants to go to 168, but it hasn't broken apart yet, that's for sure. Lockheed Martin, that is up 96 cents at 268. Now, the intriguing thing, the reason I want to look at them is that you had Trump saying that, yeah, he's going to get cheaper jets and all this. But what did happen in the budget that was just sent up last night, the defense budget, bottom line is that there was more money for Boeing jets than they even asked for. That'd be the perfect situation to basically be topping out. You stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video, giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of the Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over and take a look at the financials. Bottom line is that XLF right now is trading out here at 24.81. This is still over its high, meaning the higher range. We go take a look at JP Morgan. And, you know, as the Fed raises short-term interest rates, folks, bottom line is that these babies should be not only going, but going up pretty dramatically. Now, we'll see this how this shakes out next week on the 15th, because I suspect there's going to be two different things that the Fed has not done yet. And this is where this is going to get intriguing. So if we look at this, I'm going to put this WIRP screen up once again. And so when you take a look at this, and what that is, folks, it's the World Interest Rate Probability Screen. That's what it is. So on the 15th, that's the next Fed meeting. Well, there's no news conference set up yet. And that's why at the beginning, when this was at 39% a couple weeks ago, people were talking about, no, it's a dead meet, until all the Fed presidents came out and said, no, we don't think it should be a dead meeting. Bottom line, you get the gist of it, it goes up. Well, what has happened is that if there's going to be no meeting, will there be a statement? You know, there's going to be a statement for sure if they just go up a quarter percent. Or is it just going to say they're going to go up a quarter percent and that's it, nothing behind the move? I suspect there's going to be some kind of a statement with it, and or what they'll do is that they're going to change the aspect of, they'll say, okay, we're going to have a news conference also. Because inside that news conference, what everyone's going to want to know, number one, is this going to get more aggressive? And meaning every 3 months, are we going to go up a quarter percent? Okay, so now let's go back to JP Morgan, because if in fact that's what's going on, what you got to remember is that the way that this Fed Fund futures rate goes, this is the Fed Funds rate. This is, none of us can get this rate, but what happens is that the banks do get this rate, and every quarter point rise that the Fed goes up, immediately those banks, folks, are getting paid that interest on reserves that night. That's how it goes. That's why the amount of bread that can be made by the banks is extraordinary. You know, but right now, it, you know, JP Morgan already ran from 67 to 91. It's like, okay, you're going to run from 91 to $1.20? You know, we'll see. Right now, it's looking to me that this, you know, can certainly go test the tie up there of that 93.98, but it doesn't look to me like it wants to really accelerate dramatically. If we go take a look at Bank of America, because it already did, basically, it's breathing right now. We go take a look at Bank of America, BAC. What you're going to see with BAC, same type of setup. Now, Bank of America and, JP Morgan, they're still in their higher range, though. There's no doubt about that. Bank of America, that took off from $16, that's $25 right now. Now, the difference of a Bank of America and a JP Morgan is pretty dramatic. JP Morgan is at its all-time highs, and Bank of America is 50% below its high. $55 is the Bank of America high. So you can see the difference when you get caught over your head. And what that was all about, well, was more than about just buying Merrill Lynch. You know, J.P. Morgan, bottom line, they were the strongest out there. Let's take a look at Wells Fargo, WFC. So Wells Fargo is trading at 58.70. That's still in the higher range also. Yeah, and that's at all-time highs too. They don't have much juice up here, but, you know, bottom line is that if the short-term rate keeps going up, they should make money. The thing that hasn't happened out here, now it's happened in the metal stocks, and it's starting to happen in the gold and silver, is that the interest rate hike itself has hit those equities. It hasn't hit the S&P, not even close either. And guess what, folks? The bottom line is that if in fact rates are going to go up on a continual basis, it'll hit them. Let's go over and take a look at, I want to take a look at some of the housing stocks, because there's no doubt what ends up happening also, you know, first couple rate hikes won't be the end of the world. You start going up 1% within a year and 1.25% within a year, that would make a dramatic difference, because then you'd have a 30-year loan going up pretty dramatically that we haven't seen for quite a while. So Toll Brothers trading at 35.57. This had a nice expansion, no two ways about that. Off the lows. It's got volume on the move, yeah. Toll Brothers looks like it wants to go to 37. Right now you're at 35. Let me look at a few more of these. So let's put up Taylor Morrison. Now Taylor Morrison's interesting because this is a smaller TMHC. Okay. TMHC. So this is I know that they do business in Florida too. It doesn't say right where. So Taylor Morrison came down hard in January, making its way back up, trading at $20.46. Yeah, it doesn't look bad. These aren't saying that the rates are going dramatically higher just yet. These Home Depots in the world, Lowe's in the world, they're hitting highs. And they're not only just hitting highs, what they actually have, they're going to need more juice too. That was a one-way trip if we take a look at Home Depot. Home Depot is $28 in 2011, and now you're $146. We take a look at Lowe's. Make sure I get the right Lowe's. Yeah, L-O-W. Okay, so let's trade at 81.17. That was quite a week of strength it had last week. It goes from 74 to 82. Yeah, this is strong. This is strong. Well, what's going to be intriguing here is that they're going to have to negotiate this the rate structure. There's no doubt about it. And, you know, of course, what ends up happening, and the Tigers in the Den have been talking about quite a bit. So the question is going to be, of course, you know, if the Fed continues to go up, what does it do to the economy? How does Trump react to it? You know, all of the above. How does everyone react to it? That won't be a one-way deal. So if in fact they want to slow things down, well, that's the quickest way to slow everything down. There's no two ways about that. That being said, if in fact you don't see those sectors get hit, what that's saying, that would be saying that the inflation is higher than the rate that they're going up on, you know. And so if we go take a look at that, the 10-year right now is at 2.607. Now that's the highest it's been in 3 months. In the past year, that's the highest it's been in a year. Yeah. 1.35 is the low for the year, 2.6 is the high, right where we are actually right now. You stay right there, folks, we'll come right back.
Oh. Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per a $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
Join Andy Hecht as he shows you how to make money in commodities. The Commodities Hour, next on TFNN.
Welcome back, folks. And folks, as you come over to our website at TFNN, what you're going to see in the right in the front page, right? A live event. I'm going to be doing a live event. This is a week from this Saturday. It's an event in Tampa, Florida. It's going to be at the Westin Tampa, Florida. This is sponsored by Nadex. It's a free event. It's going to be a great workshop. Now, I'll just run you through what we're going to do here. 7:30 to 8 o'clock Saturday morning, we're going to check in, have a continental breakfast. Dan Cook from Nadex will speak for 15 minutes from 8:30 to 8:45. I'm going to be doing the first 75-minute workshop from 8:45 to 10 o'clock. Inside that workshop, I'm going to be talking about swing points, testing. I'm sorry, I'm going to be talking about quality, volume, cause and effect, and market structure, market moves, and how measured moves in the marketplace. So that's the first 75 minutes. We'll take a 15-minute break. We're going to do another 75 minutes from 10:15 to 11:30. I'm going to be talking about swing points, testing, the Tiger Gottlieb buy and sell. Then we're going to take questions for 15 minutes from 11:30 to 11:45. We'll take a break. And then we are going to have a Tiger luncheon rooftop social. It's going to be a cash bar. We're paying for the food. Check it out. It's all free. You also get a copy of The Art of Timing the Trade. It is sponsored by Natick, so they're taking care of you big time and taking care of me simultaneously, folks. So we do appreciate it. You want to go to a great workshop? Check it out. It's right on the front page. It's Wednesday. I mean, it's Saturday, March 18th. And it goes from 8:30 to 11:45. If you'd like to stay for the social, we'll have a good time up at the rooftop. You know, bottom line is that you want to come down from up north, out in the Midwest. You get the Phillies playing, the spring training, you get the Yankees, and the Red Sox are about 2.5 hours away from here. We get over and we take a look at the Asian markets out here, folks. We'll go to the Nikkei first, because the Nikkei, particularly inside the metals market, it's all about the yen. And the Nikkei itself is all about the yen. So last night, the Nikkei goes up 64 points. It's at the top of its consolidation. You know, we'll see whether they can get any juice. The top of the consolidation, the Nikkei, 19,668. That has been the top of the consolidation. It's been trying to get up and over that since December 20th. You know, last night, nothing was impressive. I mean, it does look like, though, that the low of the high wants to get tested. So if that's the case, that's quite a way up. That's 300 points up. It's 564. It's 230 points up from where we are. I don't see it tonight. The reason I don't is that last night you went higher. You had a contraction of volume. You did 1 billion shares. 1 billion shares is nothing on the Nikkei. The Nikkei has gone down with 1.6 billion, up with 1.6 billion. You know, a billion shares is a very light market. We go take a look at the UK. UK out here today, you know, went down to 72.63. Didn't stay down there. It closed at 73.14. The DAX in Germany, what we did with the DAX in Germany out here, that tried to get higher and couldn't hold higher price. Yeah, so this is going to be an intriguing night. And if we go back to the yen for a second, yen, the gold, and all of that, what you're going to see is that the yen is going to try to get up and over this 114.96. Right now, that's where it's been sold each and every time since this downdraft, folks, on the 5th of January. So the number you want to keep your eye on is actually 115.22. 115.22 is the low. Now, the 5th of January, and if you're looking at these charts, is the exact same date that's where the dollar basically got taken apart. And that's where the dollar has heavy resistance. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night. Look forward to speaking right back here tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock. Wow! Go get them, folks.
Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you will lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.